Maxime, we are going to look at movies coming from video games. And as usually, movies from video games are either very bad and very irritating, or very bad but very funny bad. And everybody's thinking Street Fighter right now. So this is what we're going to talk about today, and I can't wait to start. So what do you know?
Speaking of accents, we have a Jason Statham movie in here. So you want to move on to that one? That one's going to be an odd choice.
In the name of the king.
Just a question.
Yeah, sure.
Did they ever, you know, like apologize to the Italian community after this movie?
Why would you apologize for this? This is art. You don't apologize for the Mona Lisa.
Yeah, because Mona Lisa is a masterpiece. Please don't compare with this movie.
Yeah, I don't know what they were thinking.
Say,
and the Japanese.
As we're moving on to the next one,
sure.
That I was just doing some research, and the director is Uwe Boll.
He is about half of these movies,
and I was going to say he also is the director for Postal.
Yep.
And he is also the director for Alone in the Dark,
yep.
Which is all three of which seem to appear on most top 10 lists of worst video game adaptations.
And Blood Rain.
And Blood Rain as well. Okay.
He's done a lot of these movies, a lot of these terrible video game adaptations is the same guy.
I mean, surely at some stage after like the second version, people just say, no, we're not going to let you make a movie of our video game. We've watched what you've done in the past. No, go away.
I think he's House of the Dead too, actually, which I also have. But yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Him and then was it Mia Jovovich and who's her husband?
Paul W.S. Anderson.
Yeah, he just keeps doing these things too. I don't know.
Oh, he does, and he's terrible each time. I mean, the first Resident Evil was okay.
It's actually good.
The second one is bad, but it's a guilty pleasure. You know, you just watch it because hey, it's okay. After that, it's just insanely bad. Like insane.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. House of the Dead, Alone in the Dark, Alone in the Dark 2, Blood Rain 2, Blood Rain 3, In the Name of the King, In the Name of the King 2, The Last Mission, In the Name of the King 3, Postal, and Far Cry. He's directed them all.
It's a Far Cry movie. Oh, fantastic. I don't have that one.
Yeah, Far Cry is a 2008 English language German action film. Loosely
English
adapted.
Language German action film. Okay, that is... yeah, I don't know how
it was a major box office bomb. That surprises me.
Oh, wow.
Words I'm sure he's never heard before in his life.
How come the studio actually keep giving him projects?
They probably make tons of money, like when it goes on Sci-Fi Channel, you know, like lots of people just watch it just because it's so terrible, you know, for drinking games.
Really?
I'm not sure, because I was looking at, which is this one? This is Far Cry, and it says their budget was $30 million. What do you think they made at box office?
Two.
13 million is actually quite
low. That's very low.
For a movie, yeah.
It's very low for a movie. 743,000.
Nice. Not even 1 million. Very nice. Excellent.
Congrats. So that's why no one knows about this movie.
Yeah, but then they get it in syndication where they can like go up again. I don't know how that works with streaming, but.
How many of these movies actually made it to the big screen?
All of them, all these movies. Oh, of his movies, I don't know, but all the movies that I have trailers for were in theaters at one point.
A few of them. Here's in the Name of the King, which we're going to do now. Budget was $60 million. What did it make at box office? This one wasn't terrible.
700,000.
Same number.
I'll say half, like 30.
13.1.
Okay, so he made back his budget for the other one. That's what he's got to do. He's just got to keep going. And then, you know, his next movie will offset the previous one.
He's a magician for getting projects all the time.
He's like a gambler, right? He's like one step forward, two steps back.
Yeah, always on the losing side, but a gambler, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, in the Name of the King 2, his budget was 4.5 million. So obviously they learned their lesson and went, this is your budget this time, it's like 8% of what you had last time.
I would love to see the quality difference between the two. It probably went up.
In the Name of the King 3, also 3.5 million, which you have to imagine a good chunk of that's probably just Jason Statham's feet.
Feet? Oh, feet. I thought you said feet, and I was like, what? The movie is just pictures of his feet?
I mean, for 3.5 million, that's probably all you can afford.
Probably. Just
like a little box world. Okay, let's go. Let's see how bad this this trailer is.
Yeah, I'm going to apologize. The quality on this one, I think, is a little bit lower.
Which one is it?
This is In the Name of the King, a dungeon siege tale.
Krug, savage arm, Krug. They killed off our entire scouting park.
Sacrilege. I believe it was Galleon. He has fallen into madness. Your king needs you.
In my world, the king's arm is expected to protect the kingdom, not just the castle.
The king has been poisoned. Galleon is raising armies, vast armies.
Those who you fight, we will help you fight them.
A small force might slip through them and solve the problem at its source.
King called upon you to face death. Tonight we dress our wounds, bury our dead. Tomorrow we gouge evil from its shell.
I mean, the fight scenes from Monty Python's Holy Grail are better than that.
I mean, what did the guy who did the montage took, like cocaine or something? It's cutting every 2 seconds. I nearly died of epilepsy right now.
I was sitting there thinking, like, this looks like Guy Ritchie. this looks like the inspiration for King Arthur, the King Arthur movie he made. But yeah.
Oof. I thought you put it in fast forward at some point.
No. It's a normal speed the whole time.
The stars in this movie, Jason Statham, Ron Perlman, Claire Fulani, Matthew Lillard, Ray Liotta, Burt Reynolds.
Ray Liotta is looking a little bit long in the tooth in that one. He's looking kind of ragged.
Actually, I don't even know the video games related to this movie.
I've never heard. Yeah, that was the thing too. Is I was like, I didn't know this was a video game movie because I didn't know this was a video game.
So is this a video game called In the Name of the King?
No, I think it's a Dungeon Siege. Yeah.
Dungeon Siege.
Yeah, I don't think I know Dungeon Siege. I don't know.
Just for the fun, I think I'm going to watch this one because it looked kind of epic.
Yeah, this one, the trailer, in my opinion, didn't look awful in the sense that it looked like typical Guy Ritchie Hollywood movie. It didn't look like it was going to be like
does good terrible. Movies.
He does good movies from time to time, and he does awful movies too. Like King Arthur.
Yeah, that was terrible. I think if you watch that one, you then have to watch the other two, though, and let us know how bad those ones are. I think I've watched the first one. I think I managed to scrape through it, but I've never watched the second or third one.
Yeah, I was one of our coworkers, Phil knows him. He's also from the UK, and he loves the way Jason, was it Statham? Is that how you pronounce his name? Mm-hmm. Loves the way Jason Statham does his American accent because his American accent is just his British accent, but deeper. And so he's like, you know, I'm Jason Statham. Oh, no, that's a terrible accent. But, you know, when he does
Australian.
English, yeah, Australian, right? But when he does American English, he's like, I'm Jason Statham. it's just lower. But he sounds exactly the same. And it's like, that's how Americans sound to you? They just have lower voices? Yeah, I don't know. I can't do a British accent. I can do an Australian one. It's weird. But yeah. All right. So I think, seeing as we don't know the game, I guess we don't have too much to say about that. Moving on.
Unfortunately not.
Yeah. Moving on to other big name actors though. Would you guys like to see a Mark Wahlberg video game adaptation?